Hello, welcome to Friday for part 5 in our series of releasing tech neck, that tension in the neck and the shoulders and the throat due to many of us spending way more time in front of computer than we ever did. Some of us are spending the same amount of time in front of computers. Anyway, I'm Rose, and I'm the owner and director of the Life Force Yoga Healing Institute. Do me a favor, make sure you subscribe to our videos, like, give us comments, share with us how this practice landed for you. Another note, we've been doing 5 sessions a week here on YouTube. Next week, we move to 3 sessions. Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. I will try and post a short video with our schedule. And this is because we'll be doing live yoga practices on Mondays and Wednesdays. If you would like to be put on the list for that, you can leave a comment below, or you can email us at rose@yogafordepression.com, and I'll provide a little more information in the link when this live is done. With that said, today's practice is mantra. It's Friday, so it's a mantra practice. And our mantra today is a Hanuman mantra. So we're using a Hanuman mantra because, and I'll share this from chakra mantras, as you can see, a favorite text of mine, because this mantra uses the seed sound for the throat, which is hum. And this helps you in tune and attune with this chakra, which is the chakra of purification. It's the chakra of our spiritual truths. It's the chakra of communication. I find it interesting that this is the chakra that, one of the chakras, is really getting shut down by a lot of computer usage because of our head position. Our hearts get shut down as well, but our throats are getting shut down as we communicate via this form of technology, because our spiritual path does not lie on technology. Technology may serve our spiritual path, but our spiritual path is not technology. Technology takes us out of connection with the divine light within us. It can serve us to further connect with that divine light, like this practice may serve you to connect with that light. But ultimately, technology shuts that down. And yes, I am aware of the irony of communicating this piece of information via technology. So Thomas Ashley Ferrand, the author of Chakra Mantras, shares that Hanuman is the conscious prana that is the foremost servant of the divine self and the evolving ego mind personality. This mantra is a salute to our conscious prana. So that's why we are chanting this mantra today, to release the prana. Prana, it's the bringing forth of the eternal cosmic vibration. This is the light of our divine selves. Right now, we are in the emerging darkness. This is a dark time. And not just right now with this coronavirus, but the yogic teachings are that we are in the Kali Yuga, which is a dark time period where wisdom is suppressed. The wisdom of ourselves as divine beings is currently being suppressed. It takes a lot of work for light to overcome this. As Ramajyoti Vernon has taught me over the years, light is diffuse. It's very diffuse, yet darkness is gross, it's condensed. And so we need these practices that strengthen the light. Through our connections with each other, we are strengthening the light. We are fortifying ourselves. And in many ways, this light can create a lattice work of protection around you to outshine the darkness and ultimately to outcreate the heaviness of this darkness. So I'm going to take a little bit of tea. As always, essential oils to support this practice, peppermint and eucalyptus are beautiful for the throat. They just help open those passageways. And we've been using deep blue and aroma touch all week for the neck and shoulders. So our mantra is Om Ham Hanumante Namaha. And I'll be using this lovely gifted mala. It's blue. The throat chakra color is blue. So I thought this would be a good one. So we will do 108 rounds of this. If you've not seen me use the mala before, 108 repetitions. This is the Meru bead, the mountain that we do not cross. So we go around. If we were doing more, we would go around this way. We move the beads with the ring finger. And the mantra is held at heart level. So the left hand will cup and hold the mala beads right at the heart. And here, the mala is above the heart. And this is really symbolic of just rising above, rising out of the mud. Like the lotus flower, we rise above the mud, we rise above the darkness, and shine our lights. So let's take a deep breath in. And let it go. Soften the eyes and take a moment here to connect with that light of prana. How does this light appear for you? Maybe it's a color. Maybe it's a feeling in the body. Find the breath. Find the focused intention. I will lead you through the full practice. The last repetition will be slow to signify that we are coming to an end, and then we'll sit, and then I'll bring you out of it. So inhaling to begin. Om Ham Hanumante Namaha. 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 You are the light that shines, the inner radiance. This inner radiance. And living in this inner radiance, this is your birthright. You will always be this light. This manifestation of that divine light. In the moments when you find that you are in the darkness, that the darkness threatens to overwhelm, call upon this moment to remind you of your own inner radiance, because that light is always shining. The moments when we feel oppressed by the darkness are moments of forgetfulness, moments when we believe the lies that the darkness tells us, the lies that we are not good enough, that we don't know, the lies that we need things to make us feel better. No. You only need this connection to your divine self, to this inner radiance where all wisdom and all truth resides. When we are in connection with this divine light, we know the right path. We know who we need to connect with and what we need to take our next step. My wish for you is that you remember that you plant the seeds of connecting with your inner radiance on a daily basis. This is your pathway out of depression and anxiety on a spiritual level. This is the path out of hopelessness, your inner radiance. Thank you for joining me for this practice today. I would love to hear how this practice landed for you or any questions you have about the practice, so please put those in the comments. You are the reason that I am here, that I am offering this, and the more we connect with each other, the more I am able to serve you. So I thank you. Please have a blessed day.